the illuminance. Okay, so last class I discussed different theory means different definitions. Okay, and basics idea of the illuminations. I think all of you gone through it in your home. Otherwise, it is quite difficult to realize all those problem. Okay, basically day by day we are using the luminous intensity, candle power, the different terminology we are going to be discussed, or luminance or ale. Okay, so that portion we are discussed. So I think you should, if you are not able to go through it, so I suggest you please read it. Okay, so otherwise we cannot, there some create some confusions, okay, to understand that problems. Okay, so today I am discussed about the different laws of illuminations or the illuminance. Okay, so you know that what is the illuminations or what is E, lumens, that I have discussed in my last class. You know that what is illuminance or illuminations, E, when the luminous flux, okay, luminous flux fall on the surface. Okay, so when the luminous flux is fall on the surface, it is said to be the illuminated. Okay, so luminous flux fall on a surface, so it is said like that it is illuminated. Okay, so luminous surface is measured by the normal luminous flux per area. Okay, so that is illuminations. Luminous flux per unit area, it is called the illumination. So luminous flux, you need to know. So what was your first illuminations? The laws of illuminations of the surface depends upon the following factors. Okay, definitely, what are the factors we need to, is assumed to be the point source. Okay, so normal first consideration is that source is assumed to be the point source, otherwise sufficiently away from the surface to be regarded as such. Okay, or you say like that, how much different means distance is there. Okay, that another important thing. Okay, so the illuminations of the surface depends upon the point source you should consider and the distance. Okay, the distance from the surface of such. Okay, so the number of points is there, E is directly proportional to the luminous intensity I, or source E directly proportional to the I. Okay, so what is I? I is your luminous intensity. E is your illumination. Illumination means luminous flux per unit area. Okay, so how much maximum flux will be there? So if intensity is more, means flux will be more, so your illumination will be more, so directly proportional. That the simple thing. Next one is the inverse square law. Okay, it depends upon your distance, the second point, point source, then otherwise sufficient away, sufficiently away from the surface to be regarded as such. Okay, so inverse square law, how much distance is there. Okay, the illumination of the surface is inversely proportional to the square, the distance of the surface from the source. Okay, how much farther from, that means how much distance is there from the surface. So illumination is inversely proportional. Okay, so it is inversely proportional, illumination of the surface is inversely proportional to the square of the distance of the surface from the source. That is important. In other word, you can say like that, E directly proportional 1 by R square. So R is your distance. Okay, so proof is there, one proof is there. So from the proof, one diagram is there. So that is the related diagram. So it is your source, different radius are there. One is R, that is X radius, then radius is 2X. So that is your X. So solid angle, that is angle is your solid angle in your X axis is there. Okay, so different radius are there, X, 2X and 3X, 3 radius are there. Okay, so it is your source. So now what is your proof? The figure, that figure is mentioned here, are shown in the portions, are shown in the portion that surface of the three spheres. Okay, surface of three spheres, radii means multiples, radius means radii, are in the ratio of 1:2:3, definitely. So it is X, 2X, 3X. So 1:2:3. All these portions, obviously, all these portions obviously subtend the same solid angle of the source, hence they receive the same amount of total flux. So definitely, if the solid angle is same, okay, solid angle means the angle means that area is there and how much angle is there. So that angle is there, surface area bounded by that angle. Okay, so that you are considered the direction of the light. Okay, So if angle is same, so flux will be the same, but the intensity of the flux may be different. Basically here you know that area is less than surface area, so intensity is more, area is more, so intensity definitely the value will be changed. Okay, similarly here, okay, angle is same, but it is differ from here, means the distance farther from your source, point source. Okay, so in other words, be directly inversely proportional to 1 by r square. So how much ratio is there? 1 is to 2 is to 3. All this portion, obviously, the substance the same solid angle at the source and receive the same amount of total flux. However, since their area are in the ratio of 1 is to 4 is to 9 as per the law. Okay, so it is proportional to inversely proportional to radius. Okay, so if radius is square, you know that is inversely 1 square, 2 square, 3 square. So it is 1 is to 4 is to 9. The illuminations radius, illuminations of the ratio of 1 is to 1 by 4 is to 1 by 9. That's the concept. Okay, I think you are able to understand. The next and most important problem, okay, most important law, that is Lambert cosine law. Okay. From the diagram is given here, so Lambert cosine law, it is total F. What is F? F equals to given that flux. Last class I told you what is F. Okay, so you should remember all those stuff, otherwise, okay, so you have to remember all those technical terminologies for your better understanding. Otherwise, you're confused. Okay, the Lambert cosine law, so angle is there, that cosine angle is there. Okay, now shifted area condition one, that is totally perpendicular with your horizontal lines. Okay, now it is inclined with angle. Okay, that is theta and position is two, second position. Okay, according to this law, E is directly proportional to the cosine of the angle made by the normal to the illuminated surface with the direction of the incident flux. Okay, so what is telling that E is directly proportional, that E, what is E? E is the illumination, flux per unit area. That E, what is E? E is equal to luminous flux or flux per unit area, that is your E. Okay, so what is written? That E is directly proportional to the cosine of the angle, cosine of the angle made by the normal illuminous surface. So your initial illuminous surface was there, now it is shifted to the angle of theta. Okay, now it is coming the A dash, it is A dash equal to A cos phi. Okay, so it is shifted or inclined, definitely the directly proportional. This is, it can receive more flux. Angle is more means it can receive the more flux, that is your Lambert cosine law. So what is your law? E is directly proportional to the cosine of the angle made by the normal to the illuminated surface with the directions of the incident flux. Okay, so now proof is there. So initially you can consider four position A, B, C, D. Okay, so initially it was directly, height is h, minimum distance, height means perpendicular, angle is theta 1, it is a theta 1, now shifted to theta 2 and theta 3. Okay, three conditions are there, A, B, C, D, four conditions are there. So as per the rule, as shown in the figure, okay, it is given, let theta be the incident, theta is what? Flux incident or the F, okay, luminous flux on the surface area of A. So A is given, surface that A. When is position 1? So four positions are there. Initially there are two positions, one position, two positions. Now I am discussing this figure. Okay. Position 1, it was A. Okay. Now it is position, it is changed. Okay. So position 1, when surface is turned back through the angle theta, then the flux incident is on it is phi cos theta. So definitely flux also been changed. Initially it was A for phi, both are same. Okay, it was phi. Now it is changed to phi cos theta. Hence the illuminations of the surface when its position is 1, E1 equal to what? Illumination E equal to what? Illumination, it's luminous flux per unit area. Luminous flux was phi by A. But when position 2, it is coming equal to 1, E2 equal to phi cos theta by A. So flux line has changed. So you know, like, you know that E equal to what? E2 equal to E1 phi. E equal to cos phi. E1 equal to phi by A. Okay. So now combine all the factors together. Okay. E equal to I cos phi R square. So what is E? E in your last class we discussed what is E. It was there. Okay, so E equal to E equal to what? Illumination equal to what? Phi by A you are getting from the last class. Now you can replace all those things. So E equal to what? I cos theta by D square. Okay. That initially it was E equal to I, if there is no cos theta, so I by D. Okay, or so it, you can replace by it is R also. So in my last class, luminance L just, okay, or from there we can get that value of E. So now we can replace that value E equal to what? E, you know that I cos theta by R square or D square initially was discussed last class, it was diameter. Okay. So it was that distance we have taken. So now it is D distance is R. Okay, so I cos theta by D square. So that value we have directly put here. So I cos theta by R square. This is lumen plus per meter square. Okay. So now what is your EA? EA equal to, now you can replace that one. Okay, so you can replace that one. So EA equal to I by A square. Okay, so from that formula directly, because cos equal to what? Cos equal to 90 degree, no? Sorry, cos equal to 0 degree and sin equal to 90 degree. So cos equal to 0 degree, so cos theta equal to 1. So now place here and R equal to H given. From here R equal to given H. Okay, now you can repeat the value, so it is coming I by A square. So what is your EV equal to what? Now it is theta 1 shifted. Okay, so theta 1 shifted, now it is coming A into B square into cos phi 1. So directly taken from that formula. In last class, I have taken different formulas. So B square, I by L B square means you know that one, that B was there. Okay, in my last class, I discussed all those theory. So you can, again, you can cross check it. So you will get value. Okay, so B was there. Okay, so it was I ln by sir, it was here, then E value is there, directly you can change that value, so delta E, so that portion was there. Okay, B and L both are same, B means luminance brightness. Okay, so the expression of L was there, in my class I discussed what is the expression of L. Equal to delta I by delta A cos phi. Okay. So expression of L was there. Replace those values, it will come. Okay. I by L V square and cos phi will be there. Basically angle theta has changed. So theta equal to what? Theta 1 cos B equals to what? H B A. So B equals to your H, H equals to L, L by B, it is directly coming from that one, so and replace that value, so finally we can calculate that EV. Okay, EV equal to 1 by H square into H by LV cube. Okay, so now replace the value of 1 by H square equal to cos cube theta 1. Okay, so similarly you can find the value of EC, okay, means illumination point C and ED, both you can find out and so on. Okay, so now we need to solve a numerical problem on it. So all of it is noted down. Okay, based on the same theory, simple one. So from the numerical we can understand better. So example, what a lamp given out of 1200 lumen and all the direction in the suspend 8 meter above. So 8 meter above, so it is a Okay, it is there. So calculate the illumination at a point working plane is 6 meters away from the foot of the lamp. Okay, so 6 meters away from the foot of the lamp is 6 meters. So A is there, it is B. Okay, now we need to find out the value of luminous at 10 meters. So distance we need to find out. So it is coming root under A square plus 6, so it is 10 directly coming. So luminous intensity I equal to 1200, it is given by pi. So sphere is there, 1200 by 4, it is 95.5 candela. Okay, so from the figure we can understand that LV, that value of LV equals to root A square plus 6 square, that is 10 meter. Okay, so from it is 10 meters, so directly you can find cos theta equal to B by H, B equal to 8, H equals to 10, so it is coming 0.8. Okay, so now what is your E? E equals to coming from this formula, E equal to that E1 cos theta. So now E equal to what? I cos theta by R square. So I cos theta by R square. So you can say like that, you can replace all those values. You know the value of I from here, cos theta, you know the value of cos theta, and R is 10. Okay, R is 10, nu R. So it is your EB. Directly you can find out that value of EB, 0.7. 64 per meter square. I think you are able to understand. So all of you getting that one. So do you have any confusion? So let me try to solve this numerical problem. The next problem also be there. You can solve it. Okay. All of you are getting. So Swagat. Swagat. Am I audible? Is there anybody? Am I audible from your side?
Yes, sir, you are audible. Yes, sir, you are audible.
So, all of you will to understand? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. So, try to solve the next problem. Next problem, try to solve it. Where is multiple sources are there, so L1, multiple lamps actually, L1, L2, okay, L3 and L4, multiple sources are there, so try to solve it. So this example, a corridor is there, okay, corridor is lighted by four lamps placed at 10 meters apart, so A, B, C, D, E. So four points are there, it is 10 meter apart. Okay, they are 10 meter apart each other and suspended at a height of 5 meter above the center of line of the four. Okay, if each lamp gives 200 cp, okay, candle power, 200 cp means candle power in all the direction below the horizontal. Okay, so just below the horizontal 200 cp, find the illuminations at the point of the floor midway between the second and third lamp. Okay, so you have to calculate. So from the solutions, okay, you see it is seen that illumination at point C is due to all four lamps. C is that point, it having all four lamps. So common point you need to find out. So this is your theta 1 and theta 2. Okay, so theta 1 and theta 2, you can calculate that C position is 15 meter. It is that point, so it is 5. So both the side, it is 15 meter. Okay, since point C is symmetrically situated between the lamps, illuminations at that point wise due to L1 and L2, two points you can calculate it. So illumination due, so L1 you need to find out how much that value R by L1 C square. Okay, so that distance, know that one, that find out from here, L1 C square. Okay, directly. Okay, so it was B, so directly you can find out, you can replace all those values. Okay, L1 into C square. Okay, you have to calculate the value of L1. Okay, so now L1 C square equal to what? L1 into C equal to what? Root under 50 square plus 5 square. So directly the distance you are getting 15.8. Okay, so 15.8 you are getting. So that formula, this is your direct formula. So what is your cos theta? Cos theta equal to 5 by 15, 0.8 base by hypotenuse. Okay, so base is 5 and hypotenuse is 15 point. B by H. Okay, so it is your B, it is your H. Okay, so then L1, you need to find out illumination L1 directly. You know the formula of L1. Okay, so from the formula of L1, you can calculate that value. That L1 formula is there, L. Okay, so you have to find out that value. Directly you will get that one. L1 equal to 220 into 5 by 18. That cos theta value is there, whole divided by 250. Okay. So 200 means, and you can find out that value of 0.253 lumen per meter square. Okay, so you can directly get it from there. So now next step is you have to find out A to C. Okay, both second one you need to find out. Problem number two, that L to C equal to what? 5 by root 2 meter and theta equal to 45 degree, because that cos theta equal to 1 by root 2. So from here you will get that value of theta equal to 45 degree. So now then replace the value of L2, calculate the value of L2. It is, you can replace it here, so directly you will get that one, 2.83 lumen per meter square. So illumination of C due to L1 and L2 is 3.08 lumen per meter square. Illumination C due to 4 lamps, C equal to 2 into 10.08 into 6.16 lumen per meter square. I think you are able to understand. So another condition is there. So first you know that only one lamp is present. Now four lamps are present. So you have to calculate in the meters. Next problem is that two lamps are there. Okay, but their distance is different. Different means the length, means height from the floor is different. Okay. So another problem may also be that the different area it is there, you can also find out. Okay, so for example, two lamps A and B, I mean 200 candela and 400 candela respectively are situated 100 meter apart. 100 meter apart. So you have to find out that it is pointed same. The height of the above ground is one is 10 meter and 20 meter. It is 10 meter. It is 20 meter. Okay. If a photometer is placed in the center of the line joining the two lamps, post calculate the reading. Okay, so what are the solutions? So you have to go for the solution. Same thing, you have to again calculate the value of L1C. So L1C means that is your L1C. So it's hypotenuse 10 square plus root under square plus 50 square. Okay, it is 51. Okay, then you need to calculate L2C. So how is the value is 20 square, that is 20 square and 50 square. So that you see you can find out. So what the now cos theta. Cos theta you need to calculate hypotenuse base by hypotenuse 10 meter by 51. So for first and second case, both the theta you can calculate. Okay. Illumination at point C due to the lamp L1 is what? Okay, that directly coming from 200 candela into 10. Okay. It means your height, okay, whole divided by 51 is the distance LC1 into 600. 2600, it is coming from, it is given. That value is anything, so 26. Okay, directly it is given. So, same will come. Same for the next lamp. You can also calculate the same thing. Now, you can add both of them. So, if you this is for lamp. Okay, so next one is your lamp 2. Now, if you add both of them, so final illumination it is coming 0.066. Okay. So I think you are able to understand. Just for a moment. Thank you. Okay, so I think this is for today's session. Okay, so in next class, again, I will start with the next means different sources. Okay, they're apart from each other, and we can discuss on it in my next class. Okay, so do you have any kinds of confusion? My suggestion is that in the meantime, you please do preparations on it, keep studying on it. So if you have any kind of confusions in the next class, I'll present a discussion session. So from here, we can discuss it again. Okay. So if you have any kind of queries, anything, okay, we'll discuss it again. So you can also practice the numerical problem. I think you can understand that what are the important portions of the illumination, then different formulas. Okay. After solving the formulas, okay, so we can go for different laws of illuminations. After completions of the laws of illuminations, we can go to the different numerical problems, okay, based on our Lambert cosine law and three numericals problem we have discussed here. So in my next class, again, I will start with another studies like different sources are there, different pointed source, diffuse source, so it will be distributed the luminous flux. Okay, that will be the next target. Okay, so thank you. Today, here I am going to conclude my session. So we can go for that and in the new topics are under illumination, we'll discuss one. Okay, thank you.